champions and the leaders. 17-year-old Maria Petrova, 18-year-old Anton Sikharulidze of Russia. They were the silver medalists in Seoul and then won their gold in Colorado Springs last year.
Well, this team comes into this competition with a lot of experience. They were 8th, top 10 in the world at last year's World Championships in Makuhari, Japan.
Well, you can see right off the top of this program, they have a level of sophistication, confidence that really sets them apart from the rest of the field.
They're going to attempt a side-by-side triple toe. He does a nice one, she doubles.
Gorgeous double twist. I wonder why they don't do a triple.
Here's the throw triple salchow. Beautifully done. Here's their hand-to-hand loop lift. Watch, she steps through, puts her knee in his shoulder, and flips down forward. Unique exit. Something the judges are looking for, something different.
Side-by-side double axles. Again, she misses it, he doesn't.
She's having trouble jumping out there today. She just doesn't seem to be quite on top of herself. Strange, though, she seems to be able to hit the throws without any difficulty. Now that was a sign of a team that's experienced. They had a little bit of unison problem with that side-by-side spin, but whoever's adjusting put it back on and they exited very nicely together.
Double axle.
Again, she has difficulty with it. She doesn't seem to have any confidence when it comes to getting up into the air on her own jumps. Here comes a throw triple toe. Whoa, looks like she's lost her confidence in the throws as well. That was just a single that they did there. She didn't even take off. She didn't want to let go. As they near the end of this program, you can sort of sum this up as one of those performances which, for a pair skater, can be somewhat frustrating. Anton has looked very comfortable out there, very solid. Maria, on the other hand, has really struggled out there.
Well, the most important ingredient when you're competing is to be able to find your concentration level. And if you don't have it, it's really difficult to get through the program without a mistake.
Their concentration level was obviously somewhat off as they didn't even finish the program on the music out there.
The defending champions, Maria Petrova, Anton Sikharulidze, and you can almost tell by the body language on Anton, he's wondering, will that be enough to repeat as gold medalists here?
Many might ask, how does a judge compare this performance against that day of the Hartzels? Here we see their hand-to-hand loop lift, which in my opinion had one of the most creative exits of all the lifts we saw here. This was the compulsory lift in the short program. You watch her now step through between his head and shoulder, put her knee on his shoulder, flip down forward, nice extension here on the land. But how do you compare it? You compare it by looking at this team and recognizing the fact that as a pair team, they've got good unison, good speed, and good flow.
Nikolai Belikov is the coach, and Maria Petrova is looking at the technical marks, and now Anton will join them. And the presentation marks, a 5.7 from the Austrian judge, but a second place ordinal from Canada, a third from France, still seven first place ordinals, and it will be enough for Maria Petrova and Anton Sikharulidze to repeat as gold medalists here. The Hartzels from the United States take the silver, and Filonenko and Marchenko of Ukraine move up to the bronze medal position. Fine result for Canada's top pair, Marchant and Haas, fifth, the Sterlings, 12th, Colombe and Blanchet in their first major international are 13th.
What's special, John?
Referee Sally Ann Stapleford awarding Petrova and Sikharulidze their second gold medal at the world junior level to go along with the silver. And despite their troubles today, I'm sure we'll be seeing them at the senior level for many years to come. So Russian domination continues in the pairs competition. Regardless of the discipline, the relationship between coach and pupil is all important, especially at the junior level. Today we take a look at that relationship as we feature one of Canada's foremost coaches.
You can't be a winner without talent. That's number one. You have to be blessed with a body which has the right ingredients. If you have the right body with the right muscle structure, the right mind, mostly low-key skaters are better than the high-strung ones. And if you have all of these ingredients together and you have the ability to learn the tricks or how we call that, then you're in business. I would say teaching is more babysitting. You help them and teach them and stand over them and say, do it again. And coaching, I'm sorry, you have to be strict, very strict. I feel I'm a coach and a lot of people don't like me because I'm strict. And I want the very best for them and for me. I put my 100% in there and I want 100% back.